Power BI now gives you two ways to write your formulas. You can use visual calculations right inside a visual, or go the traditional route with a DAX measure. Now, they might look the same on the surface, but they work in very different ways. Visual calcs are flexible and respond to the shape changes in your visual, but they're stuck inside the visual. DAX measures, on the other hand, are reusable across your whole model, but not always as flexible. In this video, we'll compare both side by side so you can decide what fits your needs best. I'm Avi Singh, a Power BI Microsoft MVP, and through my online program on learnpowerbi.com, I've helped thousands of business users master Power BI and build beautiful reports. All right, so let's compare the visual calculations against DAX measures. So I had done a different video covering visual calculations, but you know what? We're gonna show you really quick. So I'm gonna remove this one from here, here, and here, and we're just gonna start over. So I'm gonna click on these three dots. You can watch that full video. We're gonna link it in the description. It's gonna be a little gradual pace, but for now, we're gonna say percentage of grand total, sales, and rows, and that's it. Click commit, and that's the percentage, and we're gonna format that to say data format, the percentage of grand total is percentage. All right, and if you've seen my visual calc video, you know I like adding some color to it just to make things look a little bit interesting. And we're gonna do it that way. Okay, great. So we're trying to compare this with DAX measures. So let's see how we could do this in DAX. Now I'll show you really old school way how I would have written it, okay? So I would go to formula, click on the three dots, new measure, and I'll say, so we'll say sales percentage of grand total. But the thing is that I didn't really know so I'm gonna write it specific to this table or specific to the fields that are here. So I'll say calculate sales, love the calculate function, lets me do anything that I want. Now, how I would write is using all. This is old school. I'll show you a new way. And all can be like a hammer or a chisel. The hammer is where you specify a table and it blows all the filters away. I generally want to be careful with that. Again, if you're using all, then I'd like to be careful. So I'm going to say calendar, and I'm going to say just the month. That's the filter that's coming in. Okay, so that's going to give me the overall sales. So not quite percentage yet, but we'll just set this in a variable. So we total sales. So for now, we'll just return this one. And so this is going to be the denominator. Now this measure is not going to work, all right? I already know that because I have beaten my head on a wall multiple times on this one. Yeah, not just once. I keep forgetting this lesson. And what was it doing? Oh, okay. Yeah, let's go here. Let's just do decimal places. So you notice that I'm telling it to remove the filter and it's not removing it. That is because that column has a sort by column. When you have that, then you need to include that. You also need to clear that filter. So it is being sorted by month num. So I'm gonna include that. And now finally, it's gonna do what I wanted to do. So again, it's giving me kind of the denominator. It's pulling this and giving me this denominator for every row. And numerator, I already have it. That is the sales, right? So I'm just gonna now say, instead of returning week total sales, I can say divide the sales, not having a great typing day, divide sales with V total sales, right? So I got the denominator, that's this, the grand total, take the sales, divided by that. Okay, and now I just need to change the format to percentage. Let's add one percentage point, and you can see that it is exactly the same. So let's keep pushing this, and now let's say we want to add that to these other tables that we had. I'm just gonna make some more space here. Okay, so let's go here. And that is kind of the first challenge. Well, both DAX measures and Visual Calc have their own challenges. So the Visual Calc, the challenge is that by definition, it is a visual calculation. That means its scope is restricted to this visual. The scope of the DAX measure is throughout this model. I can use it on any page. I can use it on any report connected to this model. So as long as I'm connected to this model, I can use the measure. So that's the good news. The bad news is that it's not going to work, right? So if I add the sales percentage, you notice that it doesn't work because the way I wrote it, it was kind of hard-coded to this structure, calendar month. So I have to go in here and I have to redefine it. So I'll say, so I can define a new measure. So I can say sales percentage of grand total, all countries, or something like that. Or I can modify this one and say, yep, all calendar. And first time I tried to write it, I tried to write it like country and it wasn't happy. It's going to tell me that it's not happy and it doesn't work. And it's saying you can't mix tables here and all. I'm like, fine, I'll just specify it in a different all. And I think that is going to work. So yeah, so that works. And ooh, what? How did I lose the formatting? Okay, so now you can see that my measure does work, but you saw that it was a little bit clumsy, right? I mean, it's just weird. Now let's go back to the Visual Calc. So either to get the Visual Calc here, either I have to redefine it. I'll have to go new visual calculation percentage of grand total again. I could do that, or you can just copy the visual. So I'm gonna copy paste the visual and I'm gonna get rid of this one. And here, I'm going to change it up so that this has the country. So I'm going to change the months to country. And of course, now it works. And again, the measure I had already modified. That's the only reason it's working. So we have both working, the visual calculation and the measure, but you're going to notice that they behave differently, at least the way this has been written right now. If I click on a specific country, so if I click United States, obviously it gets highlighted here, but notice what happens over here. Over here, the visual calculation is accurate because again, visual calculation is in a way it's simpler. It's actually going through this visual shape. It's actually going through these numbers. It doesn't really care about the filter context, anything. The DAX measures have to deal, filter context is the heart of DAX measures. You have to understand filter context. And of course, what's happening is that in this measure, notice what's happening. So for the DAX, the filter, the United States filters this and it says, fine, I don't care. I'm just gonna add them up and do a percentage of grand total. For the measure, it doesn't quite do that because the calculate takes the incoming filter context, United States, and throws it away, right? It says, nope, don't care about this. You don't matter. And that's why the numbers here are so small. They only add up to 32%. And if you take a smaller country, yeah, 6.7%. So that's not working. Now, of course, if you go back to the DAX measure, we can write it slightly differently. So instead of all, and so that's the old school way I used to write it, because I started writing DAX, I don't know, like 12 years ago, back in the days of Power Pivot, Gemini, Project Gemini, and there was no all selected. So all selected is the cool way to do this. So we can say all selected. And what that does is it only looks at the current visual. You know, so if there is like rows here, it removes those. But if there is an external filter coming from outside, could be coming from Slicer and so forth, it doesn't blow that away, right? So in a way, that's better. So now that we have the all selected, what if we try the same thing again? Notice that now it works. Now again, the syntax is still a little bit clunky. Now, of course, you could, if you wanted to, you could take it all the way and you could say, you know what, all selected. So it was like, yeah, but what if they do, yeah, let's try it here. So if we go to color sales, so let's do the same thing. We're going to take this, copy paste, so that we keep the visual calculation. And now we're going to change this to the color of the product. And so again, I want you to predict, maybe pause the video, like what is going to happen? What's going to work? What's not going to work? Well, I mean, you can bet that the visual calc is kind of always going to work because again, it's very simple. So that's the beauty of the visual calc, but the measure breaks again, right? So you can say, okay, fine, I'm going to add the all selected product color, but how many? So again, that's you seeing the beauty of visual calc in a way. It's just elegant. It's just going to work everywhere. Whereas the measure, you have to kind of really think about it. Now you can push it to the extreme and you're going to say, you know what? I don't really care. Calendar, territories, I'm just going to blow it all up. I'm just going to blow up the sales table, all selected. And bracket closed. And that does work, but makes me extremely nervous. So I'll admit, right? So I mean, like that's really... that's just not how I have generally done these things. I've been very prescriptive, like, you know, so that's been my style. But so I'm not sure if you can, should or should not do it. I think somebody smarter than me would probably comment below and says, yeah, I mean, this is why you should not do this, you know. And again, I generally don't do it. I write it kind of hard-coded. All right, so you've seen some pros and cons with visual calculation and DAX measures. And really, the thing is not to think of that which is better or worse, which is the right thing to do. Very rarely, once you go beyond the basics in Power BI, if you really want to become a pro, it's not about right or wrong, true or false. It's about understanding the choices, understanding the pros and cons, and being able to apply it in your specific scenario and making the right choice. That's what differentiates that's what makes you a Power BI pro. So if you are looking for a structured training program with live Q&A calls that help you over the roadblocks, then check out learnpowerbi.com and our training programs on there. I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Power on.